নমস্কারম এভরিওয়ান, মাই সেলফ ডক্টর সৌম্যভ চ্যাটার্জি, অ্যাসিস্ট্যান্ট প্রফেসর অফ জুলজি, দুর্গাপুর গভর্নমেন্ট কলেজ। ইন দিস ওয়েবিনার মাই টপিক অফ প্রেজেন্টেশন ইজ সার্স কোভ টু ইনফেকশন অ্যান্ড ইমিউন রেসপন্স। করোনা ভাইরাস ডিজিজ, দ্যাট ইজ কোভিড নাইন্টিন, ইজ এন ইনফেকশিয়াস ডিজিজ কজড বাই নিউলি ডিসকভার্ড করোনা ভাইরাস সার্স কোভ টু। দ্য র্যাপিড স্প্রেড অফ দ্য করোনা ভাইরাস ডিজিজ 2019, ইন অ্যাব্রিভিয়েশন কোভিড নাইন্টিন, caused by a zoonotic beta coronavirus entitled 2019 novel coronavirus or 2019 nCoV has become a global threat. Awareness of the biological features of 2019 nCoV should be updated in time and needs to be comprehensively summarized to help optimize control measures and make therapeutic decisions. Coronavirus are a large family of enveloped positive sense single-stranded RNA virus that infect a broad range of vertebrates. The SARS-CoV-2 behaves like a typical respiratory coronavirus in the basic mechanism of infection and replication, but several mutations allow it to bind tighter to its host receptor and increase its transmissibility, which is thought to make it more infectious. As the virus is capable of escaping innate immune response, it can proliferate unhindered in primarily infected tissues. Subsequent cell death results in the release of virus particles and intracellular components to the extracellular space, which result in immune cell recruitment, the generation of immune complexes and associated damage. Infection of monocytes, macrophages, or recruitment of uninfected immune cells can result in massive inflammatory responses later in the disease. Uncontrolled production of pro-inflammatory mediators contribute to acute respiratory distress syndrome and cytokine storm syndrome. This is the structure of SARS-CoV-2. The spike protein ACE facilitates binding to the transmembrane ACE2 host receptor, the envelope E protein and the membrane M protein together form the viral envelope and determine its shape. The hemagglutinin esterase protein may resemble another cell entry mechanism of the novel coronavirus. The nucleocapsid N protein is bound to the RNA genome of the virus to form the nucleocapsid. Here in this diagram, it is shown the infection mechanism of the coronavirus 2019. And after infecting the cell, the RNA replicates and the viral proteins are actually envelop the newly replicated RNA and the virus is released. Now what happens is during infection, the neighboring cells and the infected cell itself and the immune recruited cells secrete some chemokines, cytokines like IL-6, MIP-1-alpha, MCP-1, etc. And the T cells, monocytes, macrophages secretes interferon gamma, and there is a positive feedback interplay in between these two kind of chemical messengers. And as a result, the signal actually increases. Now there can be two kind of immune response. One is the dysfunctional immune response, where excessive infiltration of monocytes, macrophage and T cell occur. As a result, there is occurs a systemic cytokine storm, which results in pulmonary edema and pneumonia and widespread inflammation and multi-organ damage. But in case of healthy response, infected cells actually rapidly cleared by phagocytosis, virus inactivated by neutralizing antibodies, and minimal inflammation and lung damage occurs. But in case of a dysfunctional immune response, there is no neutralizing antibody found. So in conclusion, about the mechanism, you can say that the mechanism by which SARS-CoV-2 subverts the body's innate antiviral cytokine response are yet to be studied, but research on SARS-CoV shows that multiple viral structural and non-structural proteins antagonize interferon responses. Antagonism occurs at various stages of the interferon signaling pathway, including by preventing PRR recognition of viral RNA, by preventing PRR signaling through TBK1 inhibitor of NF kappa B subunit epsilon, TRAF3 and IRF3 by preventing downstream interference signaling through STAT1 and by promoting host mRNA degradation and inhibiting host protein translation. It is very likely that at least some of these pathways are conserved in SARS-CoV-2. Antagonism of the interferon response aids viral replication, resulting in increased release of pyroptosis products that can further induce aberrant inflammatory responses. However, further studies are going on all over the world to characterize the virus in details. Here are some selective references, and I want to acknowledge my department, that is Department of Zoology, Durgapur Government College. Thank you.